What happened at the West Pitkin at Ellis Drive crosswalk in the shadows of Canvas Stadium has some students being extra careful. It's where a 19-year-old freshman was struck and seriously hurt on Monday.
I cross this street right here all the time, and it gives me the chills.
Just a short while after our camera arrived, we captured a close call. Watch as the woman in pink begins to cross the street. A car comes barreling down the street despite crosswalk warning signs. The car slows to let her pass, but never stops. Here it is again in slow motion. CSU police are not releasing details about how or exactly where the student was struck. Cameron Kelly says crossing here can be tricky.
Because there was such a long line of cars backed up, I wasn't really sure to merge. So I actually just went up to the crosswalk and had to walk, and it's really confusing. I didn't know what to do, really. I just went with it.
There are stop signs and bright yellow pedestrian warning signs. Safe enough, some say.
And I've only been here for like 3 days. I'm a new student, but seems safe from what I've seen so far.
But some students say more safety signage and blinking lights are needed. Until then,
I'm definitely more careful. I just wait till they come to a complete stop.
It's the most pedestrians can do for now.
And tonight, the family of Anthony T.J. Avery is saying that they are in the process of donating his organs. They are asking for privacy in this very difficult time. Meantime, CSU police are not saying if the 32-year-old female driver, also a student here, will be charged in the case. Reporting live from the CEO's campus, Fort Collins, Vicente Arenas, Fox 31.
All right, Vicente.